Hello and welcome back to the D5200 channel, the channel that we hope will give you all the information you want to know about the new Nikon D5200. We're looking at the menu settings today. We've done two already, the playback and the shooting settings, and now we're going to have a look at the custom settings, which give you a little more flexibility and a little more control over the kind of pictures that you want to take. So let's have a look at those settings now. Okay, well, let's look at the custom settings. This is the back of the Nikon D5200, and in order to get to any of the menu settings, you just press the menu button here, which is at the top left-hand corner of the camera. The custom setting is the third one of the options. As you can see on the left-hand side, it's the third one down. And in order to get into the main menu, you use the multi-selector tool here and press the right-hand arrow. The top option, as always, nearly all of these things, is to reset the whole of the custom settings, but probably you'd want to reset different ones individually. So we'll just have a quick overview of what these custom settings are. The first one is autofocus, and that will have a look for you at things like autofocus priority selection and the number of focus points. The second one down is exposure. The third one is timers and the auto exposure lock and the self timer. Again, we'll look at all these more closely later on. The next one is the shooting display options, which allows you to put the viewfinder grid display on, display the ISO, the file number sequence and stuff like that, the print date, etc. The next one is bracketing and flash, and finally F is for controls, which allows you to assign the function button, the auto exposure lock button, and change the rotation of the dial and stuff like that. It's fairly basic, but it allows you just to customize that camera to how you want it and how you're most comfortable with it. As I say, we'll go back and have a look at all of these in more detail later on, but that's a brief overview of the custom settings menu on the D5200. So when you look at the menu options, which as I say you'll see here, you will see that there are six icons on the left-hand side, but there are in fact only five menu options. The bottom one is a particularly handy one, and that is recent settings. So instead of you having to claw your way through all the menu settings to try and find white balance or to try and find filter effects or what have you, you can actually go back to recent settings, which is the bottom icon on the left-hand side, and it will show you the last 20 things that you looked at. It's just a quick way of getting around, oops, not like that though, it's just a quick way of getting around and looking at those things or reassigning those things that you have most recently dealt with. And that's a very useful little tool and a very clever shortcut that allows you to get back to those settings that you have just been changing or manipulating, and either manipulate and change them further or reset them back to what they were before.